What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video, we're going to go back to reacting to Rush again. We are going to react to the next song on A Farewell to Kings called Xanadu. This is a song that I've seen that has been highly requested, so I'm excited to check this out. Got the lyrics pulled up here. And once again, if you're interested in this channel, please consider like, commenting, or subscribing if you're interested in Rush reactions, as well as other music reactions, sports, etc. It's been a little scattered this past month in terms of making videos. Very busy with work right now, but I'm trying to get as much content in before the end of May. I'll be mostly busy between now and then, so I won't have a lot of content, but I expect to get back into it again in June and through the summer, so stay tuned. More stuff is going to be coming out. It's just going to take a little bit of time, but we're going to get to the song called Xanadu. I'm excited to check this out. As I said, I've seen this as a commonly requested song from Rush, so we're going to get into it. And once again, in this channel, I'm going through all of Rush's chronology, album to album, song to song. So if you're interested in that, please consider subscribing to this channel. So we'll get into it. Start it now. I like songs like this that have a kind of a slow build like this. The ambience of this reminds me of something almost like Tool or Pink Floyd. What instrument is this? I'm curious. That's an awesome transition there to this little riff. This is awesome. I love the gradual transition into this.
Thank you.
Sounds like almost like space sounding now. Outer space, I mean. I love how the tempo is like fluctuating all over the place, but it's all thematically sounds the same. To see the sacred river out, to walk the caves of ice, to break my fast on honeydew, and drink the milk of paradise.
To stand within the pleasure dome decreed by Kubla Khan, to taste anew the fruits of life, the last immortal man. Find the sacred river out, to walk the caves of ice. Oh, I will dine on honeydew and drink the milk of paradise. Oh,
these are some great drum rolls.
Waiting for the world to end, weary of the night, praying for the light, resin of the lost Xanadu. Held
No. Yeah. Well, that was amazing. So that song, I think, was probably one of the most polished songs I think I've heard from them so far in terms of their transitions from song to song. Or, I mean, their transitions throughout the song. So it started out like a very ambient, just kind of like dull noise, which I like songs that kind of start off like that because it kind of tells you that it's going to lead into something more later on if you just stay patient kind of thing. But then I love that throughout the song, they kind of just started off with a few like, almost sounded like more like primitive instruments or something like, and then like a bell. And then it kind of led into a steady riff like the that thing. And then that led into an amazing instrumental intro. And I felt like it reminded me a lot of Fountain of Lamnith, but I kind of felt like I heard some riffs that reminded me of, I can't remember the name of the song, but it reminded me of, some of the B-side songs on Coldplay's album, A Rush of Blood to the Head. It kind of reminded me of some of the riffs kind of reminded me of some of those songs back when Coldplay was actually good. And then part of it also kind of reminded me of stuff like The Who. But there was all kinds of sounds going on in this. And I like how they layered in different instruments and different sounds as the song went along. That kind of kept you on your toes throughout the whole thing. So I really like this. The drum rolls were amazing. The guitar riffs I felt like at the beginning of the verse, like the that thing at the beginning of the verses, I really liked that a lot. But there's a lot of really cool riffs in the song. I thought it was great. I'd probably put the song in my top 4 or 5 from Rush that I've heard right now. The ones that come to mind to me are Fountain of Lamnith, Necromancer, 2112, and then this song, I think, are my top 4 that I would rank them so far. So the lyrics of this song, he's trying to cross the sacred river of Alph, walk the caves of ice, and then break his fast on honeydew, drink the milk of paradise. And what I really liked about this song that I noticed as it went along is that first, beginning of the song, he talks about he wants to drink the milk of paradise, and he's going to break his fast on honeydew. And then middle chorus, he says that I will dine on honeydew and drink the milk of paradise. And then he says, or I have dined on honeydew and drunk milk of paradise. So it's like a progressive step throughout the song. I think it's cool that they did that. I think, I'm not really sure what I think it might be in reference to some mythical story or something. I'm not 100% sure, but breaking fast on honeydew and drink the milk of paradise, it kind of reminds me of maybe like some kind of, either like a spiritual awakening or he's now made it to like the promised land in this story or something. I'm not entirely sure what it's referring to. But I think it's cool how it talks about that progression as it goes through the song. He's searching for the lost Xanadu. I'm assuming Xanadu is something to do with either the afterlife or like a heaven type of setting or something like that. But yeah. And then it's because later on he says to stand within the pleasure dome decreed by Kublai Khan to taste anew the fruits of life, the last immortal man, to find the sacred river of Alph. But then I thought it was interesting at the end, he's saying like, nevermore shall I return, escape these caves of life. So that's like kind of saying, it's like, I guess what I'm a little confused is now that he also refers to tasting his bitter triumph. So is he happy that he's in the end of the song? Is he happy that he made it to Xanadu, or does he want to get out of it? I'm not entirely sure. But let me know what you think this song is about. I'm definitely curious to hear the backstory of this and what they're referring to within the context of the song. But over the next couple weeks, I'm going to release some videos that have more Rush songs. As I said, it's going to be kind of scattered in the month of April and May. But in June, I should get back into it with more regularity like I was earlier this year. So, So stay tuned. And once again, if you're interested in more content like this, please consider like, commenting, or subscribing. All right. Talk to you guys later. Bye.